When I was a child, I used to lay in bed late at night, staring at the ceiling, listening to my father scream. Scream at my mother, scream at yet another failed masterpiece. Finally, just scream out into the darkness. It became my lullaby. And even when they took me away, the screams followed. I was once told that insanity runs in my family. It's time to make it stop.
Reeks in here.
I swear, that dog doesn't shut up!
What? Quit looking at me like that. That dog is there for a reason. Oh, all right. You can let him out. For now.
Still life.
Not how it went. Maybe...
told you never to come down here!
I wonder when was the last time this place saw sunlight.
Oh, the summer trees. So green and vibrant and full of life, but also young and inexperienced. Let's try to find them a more poignant season, where they are wiser and have some stories to tell.
No! Put that down! You are doing so well! What are you doing? Put that down! You're much too old for that childish nonsense!
The girl in red was walking through the woods, when suddenly, out of nowhere, jumped out you-know-who. Eyes glowing bloody red, teeth sharp as razors, and yet the big bad wolf did not seem to faze her. Be careful, little girl, the big bad wolf sneered. You're in fantasy land, where things ain't what they seem. Oh, shush, you big old meanie, the frightened girl exclaimed. You're the only threat in this wonderful land. With my magic crayons, I can do no harm. I can make the trees yellow, turn them upside down, turn grass into candy, make the sky go red. I can do whatever pops into my head. The wolf was unimpressed with his show of skill. You do have the power to do what you will. Alas, I humbly urge you to practice restraint, for you are responsible for what you create. You're nasty, jealous, and mean, said the little girl. I just want to have fun, and you want me to learn.
Shh.
I wish a big old rock would fall down from the sky and crush your big bad mouth into a mincemeat pie. Don't do it, I beg you, the big wolf cried. You lack scale and perspective, my sweet little child. But it was too late. His warning fell on deaf ears. Down came the rock and smashed them all to smithereens.
Finally! Are you ready to embrace true art?
Oh, the summer trees. So green and vibrant and full of life, but also young and inexperienced. Let's try to find them a more poignant season, where they are wiser, have some stories to tell.
Oh, they sway in the breeze, but are none the wiser, just like you! Brilliant! Let's add some more of the same color. That won't make it boring or predictable. They sway in the breeze, but are none the wiser, just like you! Brilliant! Let's add some more of the same color! That won't make it... No! Put that down! You're doing so well! What are you doing? Put that down! You're much too old for that childish nonsense. Finally, are you ready to embrace...
Oh, the summer trees. So green and vibrant and full of life. But also young.
Brilliant! Let's add some more of the same color. That won't make it boring or predictable.
Ah, yes, the autumn of life, when man seeks shelter from the elements. Let's see how our little hut fares when the skies grow dark. You see? In the end, all we take for granted is fragile and temporary. Man passes, while nature endures. Speaking of which, I don't think our proud stallion likes the weather. Let's brighten things up a bit. Listening. How is some soggy grass going to help here? We need to make it warmer. Won't do us any good, no matter what color it is. Thank you. That's right. The sun bestows its kind rays upon the land. It's getting warmer and warmer until finally... Marvelous, isn't it? I know it seems like a tragedy, but a beautiful tragedy is always better than an unremarkable existence.
In his own way, I believe he meant well. He wanted me to excel, hoping that when the time came, I would succeed where he failed. Avoid his mistakes. God knows he made plenty of those. What's wrong with this thing? Huh. I don't remember that being there. There. Please, please help me. It hurts. Oh, it hurts so much. I can't take it anymore. Yes. Thank you. It's so good to feel that there's still beauty in this world.
All right, young lady. Shall we continue? Right. Whatever happens, just keep looking at me and listen. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. The princess was all alone in the dark.
Princess! Keep looking at me!
And yet, she felt that the evil witch was lurking nearby.
Look at me!
And yet, she felt that the evil witch was lurking nearby. As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something moving in the corner of her eye. And yet, she did not dare to move.
Do you want this story to have a happy ending or not? Oh, God damn it! Not again! Fine! Because the princess wouldn't stop fidgeting, she was set upon by the evil witch's minion and dragged off into the darkness, never to be seen again. The end.
My fault. It was always my fault. All I had to do was stay still. Day after day, for hours on end, until he would finally get it right. I've lost count of how many attempts there were, but each one made me feel like I was his greatest failure.
Hey there. Oh, come on, don't be afraid. It won't bite. Here, try for yourself. That's not quite right. Still not quite there. Get your crayons.
Thank you. this without you. Thank you.
Oh, hey there, young lady. Shouldn't you be in bed? It's all right, you can stay. Just don't make too much noise. Daddy's working. What do you mean, who's that? It's Mommy. What? That's not what Mommy looks like? Well, she does to me.